We are going to cover a hockey topic today that is near and dear to my heart, and it's also been the bane of my existence at times. It's blocking shots in the NHL. When to go and when not to go from a goalie's perspective.
And in the case of Henrik Lundqvist, let's take a closer look at the save percentage in each shooting sequence to see where the true value of blocking the shot is versus the traditional let the goalie see it. Save percentage is calculated by dividing the number of saves a goalie makes by the number of total shots allowed. Last season, Henrik Lundqvist had an all-shot save percentage of 920, which is 5 points above the league average of 915. A clear-sighted shot is when a goaltender has half of a second of clear sight on the puck before the puck releases from the shooter's stick. Last season, Henrik Lundqvist had an all-clear-sighted shot save percentage of 977. The highlights used in this piece were all taken from the Rangers' final preseason game versus the Philadelphia Flyers on October the 6th. Let's take a closer look at the player options of the Philadelphia puck carrier. First off, Henrik allowed 0 goals last season from this location on clear-sighted shots and only 4 rebounds that ended up with secondary shots on goal. So it's very safe to say that the goaltender wants to see the puck and not be screened by his teammate trying to play goalie on such a low percentage shot. The second option is the pass across the slot line, and Henrik's save percentage last season on slot line passes was 658. So this is obviously the most dangerous play available on this sequence and should be protected. Under these conditions, the goaltender has a very difficult sight on the puck carrier as the defenseman is in the goaltending stance and does not have his stick in the passing lane. It's very fair to say the puck carrier is not nearly as dangerous as the second Philadelphia player off of the weak side post. The puck goes across the slot line twice on this goal and Lundqvist has no chance. Goaltenders across the NHL last season had a save percentage of just 78% from passes below the goal line into the slot area, just like this one here. This is one of the most difficult saves to make in a game, and the goaltender's head has to rotate 180 degrees to see the puck for the first time. So a block from here is welcomed under any circumstance. Now let's take a closer look to the specific area of the ice where a block needs to be made at all costs. We're going to draw a line on the ice here from the right post wrapping around the right faceoff dot through the slot area and around the left faceoff dot and back to the post. Anything that is shot from inside this high percentage scoring area needs to be blocked if possible. That's the player's mindset and that's going to keep your goaltender very happy. This is also an example of a goaltender's dream. Lundqvist has a clear sight of view because of the shot blocker's positioning on the right side of the shooting lane. Kevin Hayes lines up his left shoulder with the inside shoulder of the shooter. Technically speaking, this is a perfect approach. Stick is in a decent position, legs are tight enough that a block and threat of a breakaway is possible, and Hayes is in a position to move again without delay if the shot is not taken. From the goalie's perspective, this is a dynamite approach because he knows the shot across Hayes' body is no longer possible, so now the focus is solely on the single player in front on the offensive screen. Last season, when a single offensive player was standing in front of Lundqvist, he had a 98% save percentage on shots from this distance. This is one of the greatest strengths of his game. Now this is where the challenge lies. Do I go or do I not go? That's the type of situation it is. But before we go there, let's look at the numbers from this exact location last season where Henrik Lundqvist had an above average save percentage of 916. When he saw the puck for half of a second with clear sight before the shot came off the shooter's stick. However, his save percentage dropped all the way down to 890 when he was screened by his own teammate on that very same shot. That's where there is more homework to be done, but let's keep moving through this hockey game. This is the one that kills the goaltender. Because of the blocking position of the defender, you can see how his stick is on his side and not deterring in any way where the player carrying the puck wants to go, which is in the slot area. When a guy like Brady Shea has his stick in front and remains on his feet, that's at least 8 feet of room the puck carrier is not allowed to drag the puck unimpeded and use him as a screen on his own goaltender. This one is a nightmare for a goalie. You don't have clear sight on the puck, and the time and space the player with the puck has is unpredictable based on what you perceive your defending player could accomplish. Another major drawback I'm seeing around the league is the blocking player's delay to regain their feet and defend again. Like in this sequence here, I don't blame Brady Shea. He's trying to make a committed play to help his team win. Every team in the NHL is doing this right now, and if you want to stay in the lineup and not be called soft, you're going to make every effort to sell out and block a shot. The NHL began tracking shot blocking in 1997-98, and teams averaged only 676 block shots that season, and last season that number rose to 1,187. So over the past two decades, the number of shots blocked has almost doubled. And in addition to that, look no further than the proof of Ryan McDonagh and his broken hand injury late last season on a low percentage shot from the outside by Brandon Dubinsky of the Columbus Blue Jackets.
Now the takeaway for me from doing the research for this piece is that there is a time to block the shot, there is a place to block the shot, and the technique has to be on point so your goaltender can see the puck and the players aren't risking injury. Please keep checking MSGNetworks.com for more from Valley's View.